Acharya has two terrestrial sisimas, Vangris. Iskan found a chair, Jagat Guru Slesi Bhakti Vidanta Swami Prabhupada ki Jayam Vishnupad Paramahamsa Paribhaja Gacharya Astu Terasata Sishiman Divine Grace Le Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada ki Ananda Guri Vaishnavrinda ki jaya Namacharya Shri Hari Das Thakur ki jaya प्रेम श्री गुरु श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वसादि गौर भक्तवृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोपाल गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गौर वदान की जय। वृंदावन धाम की जय। मथुरा धाम की जय। नावद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। यमुना माई की जय। गंजेश माई की जय। तुलसी देवी की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। समवेत भक्तवृंद की जय। इतिहाय गौर प्रेम आनंदे ऑल ग्लोरियस असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ग्लोरियस शिशि गुरु श्री गौरांग नमो विष्णु पदे कृष्ण पृथाय भूतले श्रीमद भक्ति तीर्थ शांति नमस्ते कृष्ण पदाय प्रभुपाद शीतनमे श्री गौर कारण शक्ति वृत्ति ॐ अज्ञानातिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदन्तिकम् वन्देहं श्रीगुरुन् श्रीयुतपादकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सग्रजातं सहगणा रघुनाथन्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सवदूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादं सह गण ललित श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश कृपिका उत्साहान एंथुसिएज्म एंथुसिएज्म और टू बी एंथुसियास्टिक How can we maintain enthusiasm in Krishna consciousness? What are the principles? What are the principles that will help us remain enthusiastic in Krishna consciousness? Spiritual values or the activity we perform. Very good.
Being in the Sangha of Brahmacharya enthusiasm. Being in the association of Brahmacharya.
To be in association of those who are enthusiastic. Very good. To be grateful to Krishna. Very good. To be grateful to Krishna. Very good. Something more? We should know the goal. We should know the goal of Krishna consciousness. In this world, everybody, every, even fools, expect something from everything we do. Is it not? Even a fool So if we want to maintain our enthusiasm in Christian consciousness, it is necessary to know the goal. Why am I doing this? What am I expecting from this? If I do this, what will I gain? A friend told me that if I see money, and someone is sitting there with gun to kill whoever comes there, I will go for the money. You understand? Do you understand? If there's money, I can see that this is money. I would not mind the sacrifice I have to make to go for the money. Even if it is debt, I will go for the money. Why? Why would he take the risk? He knows the goal. If I get this money, then I will lose. He will take the risk because of the money. If I see the money, I won't mind. Anything which is there, I will not look at it, provided I see the money. Why taking risk? Because money. If we don't know the goal of Christian consciousness, we will never put effort into it. Why someone come less for a program and someone is earlier than the time? Why? Why some devotees will come late and some devotees will be there before the program starts? Why? He knows the goal. He knows the goal. Therefore, they are enthusiastic. Someone who does not know the goal, maybe nobody has come yet. Let me wait until the people come, then I can go. The sun is too high, so many people will not come anywhere. Maybe the speaker will be sick, so no need to go. Because the sun is too high, so who can come out of the sun like this? Nobody can. The sun is too high. But some people are already waiting there. While someone is projecting negativity, some people are already waiting there. They are waiting there to hear. Like my friend. He's eager. Why? He knows the goal. We must know the goal of Christian consciousness if we want to maintain our enthusiasm. Srila Prabhupada explained that. Endeavor executed with intelligence in Christian consciousness is called Utsaha. Endeavor executed with intelligence in Christian consciousness is enthusiasm. We must know the goal. Then we have to associate with those who are very, very enthusiastic in their Christian consciousness. Prabhupada gave example. A friend was inviting his friend to go for a lecture in Mayapur. Let's go for a lecture tomorrow. I'll come tomorrow. The next day, say, let's go for it. No, tomorrow. Tomorrow. Tomorrow, definitely. The moment he told his friend, the prasadam there is wonderful. It's let's go. Postponing. But now, let's go. Why? Prasadam. That's the goal. The goal is prasadam. Let's go. Enthusiasm. One must know the goal. Then we need association of those who are enthusiastic. If any phone ring in this class again, I will stop. In this class, if any phone ring again, I will stop. If any phone ring again, I will stop. Because we are lacking enthusiasm. Those who are enthusiastic, their phone will never ring in a class. Because they know that is an impediment. It's a distraction. No enthusiasm. Anything which we are not enthused in doing, we would never do it for a long time. Any little difficulty, we'll give it up. Why Haridas Thakura has to chant continuously the holy name? Why? Haridas Thakura chant the holy name continuously, non-stop. Why is he doing that? He knows the goal. If I chant, I'll get pure love of God. I'll get pure love of God. Therefore, he closes his eyes to everything else. Only Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Hare. All temptations that came, Haridas Thakura didn't see them. He's enthusiastic. He didn't see all difficulty, he didn't see. Even death cannot stop Haridas Thakura from chanting the holy name. Death cannot. Death cannot stop Haridas from chanting Hare Krishna. Because he knows the goal. He knows the goal. If I chant, I'm going to get the mercy of the Lord. And when the mercy of the Lord is gotten, all problems finished. All problems finished completely. So we need to be enthusiastic. If we are not enthusiastic, we will never face the test and pass it. Any little difficulty will be discouraged. Discouraged. If you're enthusiastic for something, there wouldn't be any discouragement. Everything will be wonderful. If one is enthusiastic, there's no discouragement. We will continue. We We will find solution to any difficulty that we meet on the way to get to the goal. Find the reason. The sun is very high, get umbrella. Finish, you go about your duty. Swarupa Goswami mentioned that we should be enthusiastic. Nishchayad. Nishchayad means what? Determination, confidence. We should be confident in Krishna. If we are not confident, any little difficulty that comes, our faith will be destroyed. Maybe I will not be able to make it. This thing is very difficult. I will not make it. It's better I don't follow it. Confidence. That Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and the source of everything. This confidence we must have. He will protect me. He is there. He will protect me. He has been protecting me since time immemorial. See, he will protect me. Krishna is there to protect me because that is his duty. That confidence we need in Krishna consciousness to become successful. Dairyat means what? What is dairyat? Why Rupa Goswami says we should be patient? Why Rupa Goswami is talking about patience? Is it wrong for any one of us here to become pure devotee now? Is it wrong? Is it wrong for anyone here to become a pure devotee now? Is it wrong? I'm asking you. Is it wrong for anyone here to become a pure devotee now? So why Rupa Goswami said patience? If it's not wrong, why patience? He doesn't want us to be pure now. Rupa Goswami doesn't want us to attain perfection now. He doesn't want. Does Rupa Goswami want us to be pure now or not? Yes means what? My questions are two sides. Does he want us or not? Listen to my question first. Rupa Goswami, does he want us to be pure or not pure? Okay, he wants us to be pure. After 1 million lifetime? After 1 million lifetime? Now? So why patience? Okay, now you can talk. Why patience? Why is it patient? Why did he say patient? Dairyat. It is Krishna's mercy. We need Krishna's mercy. And we cannot force Krishna to give it to me now. You cannot go to somebody and tell him, can you borrow me 100,000? Yes, I'll borrow you. Please, can you give me now? Please, give me now. No, I said, next week. Why next week? It's too far. Give me now.
Can you do like that? Will you get it?
No.
We have to wait for the person whom we need the help. We have to wait for the person's mercy, not our own power. Because if it is possible, you should have it. You don't have to come and beg me. You should have it. If you don't have it, and coming to me, then you have to wait for me. That's what it means. Yes. That's one reason. Second, we said something before. Why patience? Krishna want to see, do we appreciate his mercy? Krishna want to see, do we appreciate his mercy, or he is our houseboy? Is Krishna our houseboy? We can go and command him, come here, come and do this. Yes, sir. Krishna is not our houseboy. So we want to see, do we appreciate his mercy, or we are thinking that it's our right? If we get it now, we will not value it. Oh, this is very cheap. Cheap. Anything which is cheap has no value. Very good. Something else? Yes. So the Prabhupada quoted these slokas many times. Many times. A person who is very, very patient, undergoing all difficulties, but remain patient, always expecting the mercy of Krishna. The kingdom of God become his or her rightful claim. Krishna Loka becomes a property automatically. A son who wants to inherit his father's property, what shall he do? A son who wants to inherit his father's property, what shall he do? Seven places his father. Obedient to his father, yes? Be patient. So be patient. Yes. The son who wants to inherit his father's kingdom. He should stay with his father. He should not die before his father. If you die, everything is finished. Right? So we should not give up Krishna consciousness. You understand? We shouldn't give up Krishna consciousness. We should practice till the end. Dairyat. Don't give up Krishna consciousness. Either it is good or not, whatever it is, don't give it up. Continue till the end. The result will be wonderful. Patience. Patience. We should be patient because we have lost our right. Conditioned souls, we have lost our right. We have no right. Just like a beggar has no right. A beggar has no right. They have to wait for the master. See, we have to wait. Another point is that devotional service is not easy. It is not easy. It's not something that you go to college after 4 years, graduates, Haribol. No. No. It is not cheap. It is not easy. Therefore, we have to be patient. We should be patient. Tolerate everything. Because Goloka is not easy place. And when one attains that, everything is finished. No more suffering. Finished. Eternity. Eternity. So Rupa Goswami, he knows the process is difficult. So you should be patient. The process is not simple, not so easy like that. It's not cheap. There are many things which are going to pass through in the process. So we have to tolerate them. Understanding the goal, we should tolerate them. So Rupa Goswami is speaking with patience. Tat karma pravartanat. It means what? What does it mean? Acting according to the regulative principles. We should act according to regulative principles. We should follow regulative principles. This morning we are speaking about that. His Solemnity, Japataka Swami Maharaj, advising all of us, please keep to our vows we have taken. Keep to the regulative principles. When iron is in constant association with fire, what happens? You develop all the qualities of the fire. So when we keep ourselves in the line of devotional service, what happens? We will become devotional. We will develop all devotional Krishna conscious qualities. The qualities of a devotee will automatically become manifest. All the qualities of a devotee will become manifest. That is, if we keep ourselves within the jurisdiction of bhakti, so regulative principles, of hearing, chanting, remembering, and the rest. These are eternal activities for the soul. We have eternal activity for the body, right? Bathing, eating, they are activities we have to do with this body. There are also eternal activities which we have to do for the soul. Hearing, chanting, remembering. These are eternal activities. It goes to the soul. Hearing, chanting, remembering Krishna, doing service for the Lord. These are eternal activities of the soul. Rupa Goswami said we should keep to them. Abandoning association of non-devotees. Who are the non-devotees? What are the categories of non-devotees? Mm.
Who are they? Who are the non-devotees?
Materialists? Gyanis? Mayavadis? Yogis? Atheists? Karmakandis? Sahajiyas? Those who blaspheme devotees? What are unfavorable family members? Unfavorable family members. What about them? Unfavorable family members. What about them? Are they to be abandoned or should I say what? Unfavorable family members. So keep respectful distance from them. Very good. Yes, respectful distance. That's a good adjective. So we should not miss that. Anyone, any environment, any situation which does not support our Christian consciousness, they what? A satsanga. Anything. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. He said, devotees, we should be angry with non-devotees. Devotees should be angry with non-devotees. Because what? They are impeding our Krishna consciousness. Srila Prabhupada said, these people are making our preaching very difficult. For example, there are so many sadhus or saintly persons who are abusing their members, and the public are aware of it. Is it not? Ramdev Babajan. So when you go out to preach, it will be easy for you. They will not refer to him. They will refer. And there are so many. And people are aware of this. So, but this is what he said. These non-devotees who are making our preaching activities very difficult, we should show them anger. Is it not? Then he said, am I a devotee? Am I a devotee? Am I a devotee? So whom should we show anger to? Ourselves. We should show the anger to ourselves. Look at our activities. Does it discourage others or is it encouraging others? If in any way we are acting which is discouraging on anyone, we should be angry with this help. Because that is not activity of a devotee. A devotee acts in such a way that everyone benefits. See Srila Prabhupada. He established a society for everyone. Is it not? Srila Prabhupada. Creating fortune, auspiciousness for the whole world. He's a devotee. They say this and Amesha Ranya, they are sitting together for a 1,000 years sacrifice just to help the whole world. It's a devotee. If we don't act like this, our activities are discouraging someone from Krishna consciousness. That is not a devotee life. So we should act according to the principles of devotional service. Everyone will be encouraged. That's a devotee. Giving up all bad association and to keep association with devotees. And then he said, we should follow in the footsteps of the acharyas. What does it mean, following in the footsteps? We explained it the other day. Following footsteps means what? For example, Haridas Thakur. What does it mean by following Haridas? The six Goswamis, you should follow them. Or Prabhupada, you should follow. What does it mean? Following in the footsteps. Like what? Like what? What practical activity is? What of their life? What of their own life? We should follow the austerities they perform. We should follow the sacrifice they made. We should follow.
Hare Krishna.
Don't take the good part and leave the difficult part. Follow is follow. The austere life they live, we should live like that. The practical life they live, we should live like that. We should live practical life as a teaching to the whole world. They chanted Hare Krishna ceaselessly. Let us chant ceaselessly. They made a lot of sacrifice. Let us make sacrifice. This is sato every day, following the footsteps of acharyas. They give priority to spiritual activities. We should follow that. Deny themselves of the bodily demands. They deny that. We should deny that. Go for the best. So Rupa Goswami said, these six principles undoubtedly is a confidence. He has confidence. He's also giving us his confidence. These six principles undoubtedly assure the complete success of pure devotional service. Conclusion. This is a conclusion. It's giving their confidence. Anyone who follows this is guaranteed complete Krishna consciousness. Anyone who maintains these six principles, pure devotional service is guaranteed, confirmed. Anyone. Is it clear? And Prabhupada just gave a very powerful statement here. Devotional service is not a matter of sentimental speculation or imaginative ecstasy. Its substance is practical activity. The substance of devotional service is what? Practical activity. Not just philosophy, practical activity. Philosophy alone will never change anyone. When Srila Prabhupada spoke philosophy about Gita to the devotees, after speaking philosophy, what else did he do that changed everybody? What else? After lecture, what? After Prabhupada has given lecture, we are not the body, we are spirit, soul, part and parcel of Krishna. We should surrender our life to Krishna. After that? Srila Prabhupada took one apple and cut it into pieces and took one and shared everybody. They became devotees. A piece of apple. Just a piece, not the one apple. The only one piece of apple. You throw in the mouth, nobody will notice anything there. People changed. So he said here, devotional service is not a matter of sentimental speculation or imaginative ecstasy. It is what? Practical activity. A piece of apple, he divided for everybody who attended the lecture. At the end of the lecture, take one piece of apple. Just take one piece. Today you are eating full plate of prasada. Papa gave one piece of apple. Then gradually, plate of prasada. We are going directly into a full plate of prasada. 5 times. The substance of devotional service is practical activity. Practical activity. That means devotional service means what? Execution. Execution, activity. Means activity. You have to do something. So it define how what is pure devotional service. Anya bila sita sunyam. Gyana karma adi anavritam. Uttam bhakti should do what? Uttam bhakti is what? Sunyam. Uttam bhakti is sunyam. What is sunyam? Gyana karma adi. Sunyam. Sunyam means zero. Make nil. Karma, nil. Gyan, nil. Adi. Adi means others, like yoga. Nil. Desire for liberation. Nil. Not this. To desire for liberation. Make it zero. Rupa Goswami said. And then what? Anukulena Krishna Anusilanam. That is bhakti uttama. Exclusive devotion for Krishna. Exclusive devotion. Mean devotion only for Krishna. not for demigods, not for anything, only for Krishna. That is pure devotional service. Uttam Bhakti, or unalloyed devotion unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, involves the rendering of devotional service in a way that is favorable to the Lord.